And that's what we like to see, is a nice glowing coal just like that. Hey, this is Rob with Adventure IQ. And today we're going to talk about bow drill and creating coals just like this. I'm going to talk very quickly about bow drill sets, what it comprises of, what I carry with me when I go out to the woods, a little bit about what primitive man would have done. So bow drill has been something that has become an addiction with me in the past couple of months, and I really need to thank my mentor James Stone for that, because I have always struggled with bow drill really into about the past 8 months. And just through his mentoring and his tutoring, I've really come a long ways with him. Still not a master. I really consider him to be the master of it. And he even has me doing hand drill techniques. So let's talk about the components that you find in bow drill. And the first thing, by the Hallmark piece itself, is a bow. Now, I've made a lot of these out of different types of woods and cordages and everything else. And what I find, or what I found this last weekend, again, thanks to James, was I was making my bows really too long. So when you go to make your first bow, it should only be fingertip to armpit. And then something else that James taught me, and I'll show it in another video, I've actually hauled out two holes. You could use a drill if you want. I was trying to keep things the way I would do it in the woods. So I did all out the two holes, and then that allows us to provide tension and everything else. So that's the centerpiece of bow drill. Then what I have right here is bow drill sets. This is what I take with me out to the woods, because there's no need to go out, and it's really not a requirement that you go out and find materials to go make your bow drill set at that point. Now, I know guys that do that, and it's another part of the challenge. It's something that I've done up in the Owyhees, find things that are readily available. Today, when I was up in the mountains, everything is soaking wet. It's either been rainy or snowing or icing or whatever. And it's just, at my experience level, I'm not going to find things that I can work with. Primitive man would have done the same thing. Primitive man would have carried, and we know from the research that was done on Otzi, the mummified prehistoric man that was found, they carried fire-making materials, including things to catch tinder, such as chaga, things like this, or just other fire-making materials. So I carry my stuff with me, and then while I'm out there, I'll look for other materials for next fires, because you always want to be thinking about the next fire you're going to do or future fires. So for example, today I was out collecting cottonwood and what I think is black locust and a few other things. So you have your bow, and the next thing that you have is your hearth. Inside the hearth sits the spindle, and this works back and forth as the bow, since the bow is wrapped around it, like so, and causes that back and forth action. Now, all woods are different as to amount of pressure, the downward pressure needs to be placed upon it. To do this, you use the bearing block. The bearing block is what allows downward pressure. Some woods like a little more pressure than others, some a little less than others. And then I don't get wrapped around the axle as far as softwood on hardwood, hardwood on softwood, like woods, unlike woods, things like that. I am just experimenting with different types of woods. So today I've been working with cottonwood, rosewood, yucca, and then willow. So I've got willow and cottonwood that either has been gifted to me, or the willow specifically came off of my neighbor's tree, Dustin. So Dustin, thanks, doing good things over here. So anyway, that's the primary components of the bow drill. And again, where I stand is that I take my components out with me to create fire. You're not, as you saw in the video here, if you've never done bow drill, as you saw in the video, it creates a coal. You don't get this flame coming up. You get a lot of smoke, but you don't get a flame coming up. What you get is a coal, and then you have to have dry tinder that you place that in, and then you blow it to life. You probably, hopefully you've seen that in other videos that we have. If you haven't, go check out our videos over on YouTube, Adventure IQ. Also, please check out the Adventure IQ website, www.adventureiq.com, and you'll find some different interesting things there. I've got some other projects I need to do here in Bush Lab today. I need to make a belt. I need to remake a knife case. And then I also need to work on my some more of my friction fire stuff. So until then, we're out.